All right, so this is a AP and then lateral angiogram of a patient that I saw recently who had carotid disease. And so this is the AP view, and you can see the internal carotid artery is kind of overlapped with the external carotid artery, but you get the sense of this irregular mountain-like slash bite out of the side of the blood vessel here, which is an atherosclerotic plaque, which is ulcerated, encroaching on the lumen of this patient's proximal carotid artery on the left. And this is the lateral view. So you can see an external carotid artery here, which is mildly stenotic. And then again, a very ugly looking, ulcerated, irregular plaque encroaching on the normal lumen of the internal carotid artery here, resulting in about 65 to 70% stenosis. So this is what we often face in this disease process. All right, to go back to the basics about atherosclerosis and blood vessel anatomy. So just basic blood vessel biology is that these artery wall has three layers, the tunica intima, which is really just an endothelial layer, a very thin but important layer that is the interface with the red blood cells and the intravascular cells that are circulating. It's a thin layer of connective tissue. Tunica media, which is the more middle portion here, elastic and smooth muscle mixed in there, provides much of the elasticity and contractile component of large blood vessels. And then the adventitia, which in this slide is stained blue, which provides a lot of the tensile strength to resist dilations and fusiform aneurysms and that type of thing. And those can grow when this is violated. Also, the blood supply to the artery itself is in this region as well, the vasopressorum. So what happens when you have an atherosclerotic development in a lumen of a vessel? So it's a disease of the arterial wall, and it starts at certain often stereotyped susceptible sites in the major conduit arteries. I mean, the obvious ones are arteries of the legs, coronary, carotids, and even to some degree intracranial. And so you have an evolution of something called a plaque, which is a buildup of fatty cells that is then layered upon by inflammation reaction in the vessel wall itself. So in this slide, you have a normal intima, media, and adventitia. And then on this side, you have a lipid-rich accumulation of cholesterol type lipids in the vessel wall here. And then you're going to have a fibrous cap eventually form as a secondary to longstanding inflammation. And this is a bit more of an advanced one, a larger lipid-rich core in a thinner fibrous cap, which is continually trying to layer new layers of fibrous tissue over it to protect the vessel lumen. And often when you have a plaque rupture, this fibrous cap breaks and you have a violation of the intima with blood cells that are passing by being exposed to the lipid-rich necrotic core, thrombus forms, and you have strokes. So that's generally how this progresses to become symptomatic. So what happens early on? First of all, you have an early fatty streak development. This can happen as early as in childhood, just slight changes in the vessel wall. Then you can have an early fibroatheroma in your teens and into your 20s, advancing into a true atheroma, which is more like what you see here, over the age of 55, and you can advance further into complex lesion development with necrotic areas, calcifications, and areas that are prone to rupture. This is just like a little bit of a graphical representation of that. So it's showing the intima, the endothelium, the median adventitia, smooth muscle cells, et cetera, early atheroma. You have this enlargement where this becomes vulnerable. You can have a rupture in the plaque, which then clot forms. And or you can go from this to a more stabilized plaque where you have a lot of scar buildup and fibrous buildup protecting the vessel lumen from the atherosclerotic necrotic core. And then even that though can eventually develop into this complex situation where you have a small lumen and flow restriction leading to ischemia, But the most common type of ischemia is this one where the plaque ruptures, clot forms, and there's distal emboli.
Hey everyone, Ryan Rad here from neurosurgerytraining.org. If you like that video, subscribe and donate to keep our content available for medical students across the world.